Hey guys, Dan here from VHIX411. Today in front of me, I have a Mercedes Sprinter or Dodge Sprinter, ECU, WSP module, and of course, a key. In this video, I will show you how to fix the no start error on the dash. The older Mercedes or Sprinter, Dodge Sprinters, there was an option on a Bridas programmer to program WSP, which it has HC08. Here, let me pull it up on my right here. So they had an option of repairing the file from WSP. It has a processor inside HC08, and of course, repairing the file from the ECU. The ECU has a 94C08 or SP08. In this case, this is a newer ECU. This is an 0506. This is a CR342. And there is no option, according to Bridas, to repair this file with this file. Now, the no start happens is when this WSP or the ECU file is corrupt and they are not synced together. So they don't see each other. Even if you have a key, these three need to see each other in order to start. So that's what happens. The WSP is not matching with the ECU and does not start the car. So I did contact the Bridas, and the only option we got left to do on these is to virginize this ECU. So what I'm gonna do is virginize, clear all the keys information, make it like brand new. And as soon as the customer installs the key, it will write the key information directly to this ECU and it will start. So the older way of fixing these with programs, it's not gonna work. So the best way to do it is to virginize it. Now, if you need to virginize this ECU or any ECU you have, there'll be a link at the end of the video or at the bottom of the video. If you do have a Bridas, I'll show you how it's done. Now, also, if you need to program these on other Mercedes, we do that too. All right, let me hit my Bridas. Let's actually go read this key information and I will show you what's in it. Let me exit out from Bridas and I will go to my Bridas key programming option. And it's reading the programmer. As soon as it sees the programmer, we'll head into it. All right. So read, detect key. So it will read the key information. As you can see, this is the key information in it now, right here. This is the key. This is the transpatron stream. So this is the key information. So 660F33 and then goes on. So this guy, it has to match in this computer in order to start. Now with the Bridas, you can actually modify this. We don't want to touch anything. We want to leave the key original. That way we're just programming as soon as the key is inserted. So let's just get out of here. As you can see, we will get to my Bridas programmer and it will read it, communicate with it. Now, the good thing about Bridas, you always have to unplug it as soon as you're switching from programmer to the OBD programmer. X this out and restart it again. All right, so we're using the OBD. If you can see, I got my OBD connected here through my outlet for the CR3. As this, you can see the CR3, so it is connected, and it's connected to my Bridas up top over there. So let me go to special functions, DOS. We're gonna read the ECU, and we're gonna read the keys and what's in it. Now, if you do like what you see, click that like button. If you got questions, you can put them down in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks for watching for now. All right, so no communication. Of course, it's not gonna communicate because I did not give it power. All right, now that we have power, let's reread it again. Hopefully it's reading perfectly fine. All right. Got all my keys over here, information, if you can see. Now let's find the key that we read earlier. So we read the, let me pull it up over here on the screen. Took a screenshot of that. So you can see 660F, and then it goes to 52, 24, 07, 74. So totally off, way off than what it is. It starts with 660F, that's about it, you know. So what we're gonna do, we're just gonna clear all these keys out. And then as soon as it's gonna be cleared out and inserted in the car, it will program any additional keys. So these keys, we're just gonna virginize it. I mean, the other option, if you've seen, we can write this number into that key where into the programmer where we had the option to edit it. We can write this in and then it'll start the car. But the best way to do it is just virginize it, key inserted, and you can insert up to 8 keys and it will program them automatically. So virginizing, we'll just hit the virginize. I already read the file earlier, the FBS file saved in case. Also read the coding of the vehicle in case. We're not gonna be reading also. So if you can see, boom. I literally just, it's not personalized, not activated, and there's no keys. Now, the VIN number, we're not gonna be writing the VIN number because this is the original VIN number of the car and we will leave it that way. So as you can see, zeroed out, when the key is gonna be inserted in the car, this will start the car. So if you do have a no start error on a Mercedes or a Dodge Sprinter, on the newer one, this is the way to do it. Virginizing it, and they will program keys automatically. The older ones, you still need to link the file from here with here, and then do with the program to link it together and then rewrite it in there. All right, thanks for watching. Like this video, subscribe if it's your first time. I will see you in the next video.